Morning friends, today we have been discussing some problems on chapter complex numbers. So see here, the first problem is if z is equals to 2 minus 3i, then show that z square minus 4z plus 13 is equals to 0. Okay, so first of all, here given complex number is given that z is equals to 2 minus 3i. First of all, we have to take this constant into LHS cell. Now it is becomes z minus 2 is equals to minus 3i. Now squaring on both sides, then you get z minus 2 whole square is equals to minus 3i whole square. Okay, now it is in the form of a minus b whole square. Expand it, you get z square minus 4z and plus 2 square is equals to 4. It is equals to, here you get 9i square. According to Euler mathematician, we know that I square is equals to how much? Minus 1. Okay, substitution here, you will get z square minus 4z and plus 4 is equals to, put I square value is equals to minus 1, then you have to get minus 10. Next step is you have to take this minus 10 into LHS cell. So therefore z square minus 4z plus 4 and this one is becomes plus 9 is equals to 0. Therefore the final answer is z square minus 4z plus 4 plus 9 is equals to 13, is equals to 0. Okay, so here the given problem is if z is equals to 2 minus 3a, then we have to show that, then we prove z square minus 4z plus 13 is equals to 0. Okay, next second problem is show that z1 is equals to 2 plus 11i by 25 and z2 is equals to minus 2 plus I by 1 minus 2i whole square are conjugate to each other. Okay, what is the concept of conjugate? So conjugate means, for example, here I am taking, let us consider z is equals to x plus I by, be a complex number. Okay, so next its conjugate, its conjugate is denoted by z bar. Okay, so z bar is equals to x minus I by, x minus I by is the conjugate of this complex number. Using this concept, you can solve this problem easily. First one, here given that z1 complex is equals to 2 plus 11i is divided by 25. Okay, and z2 complex number is equals to minus 2 plus I by 1 minus 2i whole square. Okay, students, observe the first one. The first one is 2 plus 11i by 25, but the second complex number is minus 2 plus I by 1 minus 2i whole square. That means you have to simplify the second one, z2. After simplifying the second one, okay, you will get, suppose you will get 2 minus 11i by 25, then automatically they are conjugate to each other. That is the concept. Okay, so first of all, you have to simplify z2. So it is equals to minus 2 plus I by x by a minus b whole square. So 1 plus 4i square minus 4i. Next, it is equals to minus 2 plus I by I square. Already we have I square value is equals to minus 1. Okay, submit here. You will get 1 minus 4. 1 minus 4 minus 4i. So it is equals to minus 2 plus I by 1 minus 4 is equals to minus 3. So minus 3 minus 4i. Okay. Next is simplification. It is equals to minus 2 plus I by, so shall I take minus common here?
Yes.
We will get minus of 3 plus 4i. Same like that, here we have to take the minus common in numerator, then we will get minus of, okay now? So 2 minus I, minus minus get cancelled. So it is equals to 2 minus I by 3 plus 4i. What is the rationalizing factor of denominator? 3 minus 4i. Okay, so that's why you have to multiply and divide into 3 minus 4i. So by 3 minus 4i. is equals to max simplification 2 into 3 is equals to 6 minus 2 into 4 I is equals to 8 I. Next minus I into 3 is equals to minus 3 I. Minus into minus becomes plus 4 I into I is equals to 4 I squared by next. Now it is in the form of A plus B into A minus B. You will get 3 into 3 is equals to 9 and plus 16. So therefore it is equals to I squared is equals to minus 1. So thus we get 6 minus 4 minus 8 I minus 3 is equals to 11 I divided by 9 plus 6 is equals to 25. Next, the last step is equals to 6 minus 4 is equals to how much? 2 minus 11 I is divided by 25. Finally, we are getting 2 minus 11 I by 25. That means the conjugate of 2 plus 11 I by 25 is the 2 minus 11 I by 25. That's why here J1 and J2 are conjugate to each other. Conjugate to each other. That is the concept. Next, the third problem is most important. Already it is given in March 2020 for 4 marks. Okay, listen carefully, students. If x plus I y is equals to 1 by 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta, then we have to show that 4x squared minus 1 value is equals to 0. Okay, so first of all, according to problem, here given that x plus I y is equals to 1 by 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay, what is the real part here? 1 plus cos theta is the real part. What about the imaginary part? Sin theta. Okay, so rationalizing this one. The rationalizing factor of denominator is 1 plus cos theta minus I sin theta, okay, by 1 plus cos theta minus I sin theta. Okay, next simplification, it is equals to 1 into this one is equals to, you get this one only, 1 plus cos theta minus I sin theta whole by, all of you have seen here. Now it is in the form of A plus B into A minus B. Our formula is A square minus B square. Applying here, you will get 1 plus cos theta whole square and minus I square sin square theta. Next, it is equals to 1 plus cos theta minus I sin theta. Okay, whole by. Expand A plus B whole square formula. 1 plus, so 2 cos theta plus b square means here cos square theta, and you will get here sin square theta. According to trigonometry, we have sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to how much? 1. Okay, submit here. So this value is equals to 1. It is equals to 1 plus cos theta minus I sin theta whole by, this value is equals to 1. 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Okay, so 2, 2 be the common. So 2 of, you will get 1 plus cos theta. Okay, and so this one, you will get denominator 2 of 1 plus cos theta. Next, it is equals to, expand it. You will get 1 plus cos theta by 2 into 1 plus cos theta minus I into sin theta is divided by, so next to 2 of 1 plus cos theta. Next, here 1 plus cos theta, 1 plus cos theta cancel. Okay, finally here I am getting x plus I y is equals to 1 by 2 next minus I sin theta whole by 2 of 1 plus cos theta. The next step is equating on both sides, real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. But here our requirement is only real part. So therefore, here the real part x is equals to 1 by 2. But according to problem here asking, show that 4x squared minus 1 is equals to 0. Next, now 4x squared minus 1 is equals to, put x value is equals to 1 by 2 here. You will get 4 of 1 by 2 whole squared minus 1. So it is equals to 4 into 1 by 2 whole square is equals to 1 by 4 minus 1. 4, 4, it cancels. So finally, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Yes, I'm getting 4x squared minus 1 equals to 0. Okay, next, fourth problem. Find the least positive integer of n. For satisfying, 1 plus I whole to the power of n by 1 minus I whole to the power of n is equal to 1. That means, totally, 1 plus I by 1 minus I whole to the power of n equals to 1. So here, we have to find the least positive integer of small n value. First step. First of all, we have to consider the bracket term. The bracket term is 1 plus I by 1 minus I. Okay? So, rationalizing of the denominator part is 1 plus I. So, that's why you have to multiply and divide by 1 plus I. Okay? Clear everybody? Next, simplification. 1 plus I into 1 plus I is equals to 1 plus I whole square is divided by a minus b into a plus b is equals to a square minus b square. That means 1 minus I square. Already we know that I square is equals to minus 1. It is equals to simplification. 1 plus I whole square is equals to 1 plus I square and plus 2i divided by put I square value minus 1. Minus and minus becomes plus. 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Already we have I square is equals to how much? Minus 1. It is equals to 1 minus 1 plus 2i whole by 2. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. Here 2, 2 also cancel. Finally, the result is equals to I. But here I have whole to the power of n. So therefore, you will get I to the power of n is equals to 1. That means I to the power of n is equals to 1. According to the problem here asking, find the least positive integer of n. That means you have to check the n value. So first, put n is equals to 1. Submit n is equals to 1. You will get I. So therefore, I is equals to 1. Does not satisfy. Next, put n is equals to 2. Then it becomes I square. We know that I square is equals to much? Minus 1. This value is also does not satisfy. Next, put n is equals to 3. So therefore, I cube is equals to how much? I square into I. It is equals to minus I. It is also not satisfied. Finally, put n is equals to 4. So therefore, I to the power of 4 is equals to. Shall I write this I to the power of 4 as I square whole square? Yes. So therefore, it is equals to I square value minus 1 whole square. Minus 1 whole square is equals to much? 1. Yes, it is satisfied. I to the power of 4 is equals to 1. So that's why our least positive integer value n is equal to how much? 4 is the correct answer. Next, fifth problem. If a plus I b whole square is equals to x plus I y, then find x square plus y square value. Okay? So first of all, here given that a plus I b whole square is equals to x plus I y. Okay? Next. Now, expand this one. A plus I b whole square is equals to a square plus I square b square plus 2abi is equals to x plus iy. Okay? Next, I square value is equals to minus 1. Next, a square minus b square. Next, plus 2abi is equals to x plus iy. Next, equating real and imaginary parts on both sides of this equation. Okay? Here, the real part x is equals to a square minus b square. So therefore, now x is equals to a square minus b square. And here the imaginary part value y. So equating this y is equals to 2ab. Okay? So 2ab. But according to problem, we are asking find x square plus y square. So therefore, now x square plus y square is equals to. Already we have x is equal to so much a square minus b square whole square. Okay? So whole square plus 2ab whole square. Okay? Next is simplification. So it is equals to a square minus b square whole square plus 2ab whole square is equals to 4a square b square. This total value is nothing but a square plus b square whole square. This is the value of x square plus y square. This is the concept of this problem. Okay, dear students, today's homework is the first one. If z is equals to 3 minus 5i, then show that z cube minus 10z square plus 58z minus 136 is equals to 0. Okay, here the hint is, first of all, cubing on both sides, you will get z cube. Next, squaring on both sides, you will get this one. Next, j, multiplication with 58. Next, subtracting 136, you will get all the terms get cancelled, you get 0 is the answer. That is the hint. Okay, same like that. The second problem is, if z is equals to 2 minus I root 7, then you have to show that z cube minus 4 z square plus z plus 88 is equals to 0. Okay, same model. Next, the third one is, show that 2 minus I by 1 minus 2 I whole square and minus 2 minus 11 I by 12 is a half conjugate to each other. That means you have to simplify the first one, then you will get minus 2 plus 11 I is divided by 25. Then automatically this one and this one are conjugate to each other. This part works. Okay.